Hey guys, it's me Anastasia, welcome to my channel. Today is going to be a very special video, I'm finally going to test these super cheap alcohol-based markers. This set of 12 pastel shades costs only about $5. They are alcohol-based and have chisel tip and fine tip from other side. From what I see now, they look super cute. I wrote down all the color numbers in my sketchbook with special marker paper, and now let's do the swatches. I'm not hoping that the color is going to match the caps. Oh, I wasn't expected to get such fluorescent colors, such this orange and yellow shade, and there was no swatches on the side, but other shades look very pretty. I wanted to create something magical and sweet with such cute pastel shades. So I designed this magical Farbengirl. And this time I decided to sketch right into my sketchbook and not trace the drawing from print to paper because sometimes it's very hard to see and I'm doing a lot of mistakes. I think if I would have a light pad, it would help a lot. Also, lately I've seen a lot of big artists doing their line art digitally and then print it and just color it. What do you think about this way, guys? It won't work for sketchbook for sure, but what about single pieces? I think such method is helping to save the sketch vibes. I hope you understand what I mean, because even if you look at my sketch, it looked a bit different than a bigger piece. It's very hard to transfer the sketch to a larger piece of paper and make it look exactly the same. Of course, you can do a grid and erase 1000 times to make it look exactly the same, but in my situation, it's going to damage the sketchbook paper. When I'm erasing only a few times, the paper already began to look textured and damaged. Yes, it works great with markers, but it's not for erasing. And now I want to talk a bit about these markers. I really like almost all of their shades, but while I was working, some of these markers were half dried. The blue shades and green. And the green color was light fading so fast. I create two pieces with this set, and on the second piece I viewed this green shade, and I almost couldn't see it after I finished it. It is so sad. I was so disappointed at that, because first I was very happy that I finally found a nice pastel green shade. The markers were brand new and I think at least they're supposed to be full of ink and not half dry. For example, I've got a Copic Chao markers and I never refilled them. I've got them for 2 or more years and they draw perfectly. They're not dried out or something. So this was a total fail. I'm not recommended to buy this brand of markers to anyone. Better spend a bit more, but get a better set of alcohol-based markers for artists. Even though I still like how this cutie came out. I've used almost every shade for this piece, but still 3 colors left. Green and super bright yellow and orange. I really didn't know how I can include these shades to this piece and not ruin it. So I decided to do one more test drawing, where I'm mostly going to use these 3 colors. As these yellow and orange shades are so vibrant, they remind me a lot of pop art style. So I decided to draw a girl in this style. Previous girl came out very tender and sweet and light because I was using very thick brown lines. And for this drawing, I'm going to use dark bold lines. I really created this illustration back then, before this sad situation, when I broke my 0.3 size liner nib. I'm already ordered it, so I'm waiting patiently. And for the hair, I'm using multi-liner brush from Copic. I love to draw such curly hair, you can go very creative with it, and you don't have to try very hard. It always turned out very cute. Especially if you are using a brush liner. Lines of different thickness create very cool effect. This drawing was very easy to color, I decided to make her hair yellow and added one layer of this fluorescent color. I was leaving white space as the highlights. I colored her bow and t-shirt in orange shade. I'm not sure that I can layer such fluorescent shades to achieve some shadows, so in the end I decided to add some shadows to her hair with the orange shade. At first I didn't plan to color her skin, but I think without it illustration would look a bit empty. So the piece is almost done and I've used every single color from this set. You can see now how bad that green pigment is. It is almost invisible. And after I apply it, it light fading so fast, it is very bad. But no matter how bad some of those markers are, I'm very happy with final result. And what do you think, guys? That's all for now. I hope this review video would be helpful for someone to not make same mistake as I did. And if you like how these pieces came out, don't forget to support me with your thumbs up, comments. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel to not miss next video. I love all of you. See you next time. Bye bye.